Hi, everyone. Welcome to our Kids Church family experience. My name is Viv Stone, and I'm the Kids Church pastor here at Christian Assembly. We're so excited. It's December, and we get to celebrate Jesus' birth all month long. It's Christmas Kids Church style. In your Christmas kit, you each got one of these fun snowflake necklaces. Why don't you go get it and put it on? All month long, when you watch Kids Church, let's wear our necklaces so we can celebrate together. As I told you before, we have so many fun and meaningful things planned for you, and we can't wait to roll it out each week. We have been taking steps recently to get us ready to invite a friend or a family that doesn't know Jesus to watch our December 19th Kids Church service. Last week, which was our first weekend of Advent, we did a listening prayer to ask God who He wants us to invite. Later in today's service, we're going to pray together and ask God for boldness and courage to invite them. This coming Saturday, December 12th, is the pickup for a Kids Church Christmas invite kit full of everything the person you invite will need to participate in the service on the 19th. Pickup is from 11 to 1 in the Kids Church tent. More information can be found on our website. Moms, dads, kids, don't forget to invite your friends and pick up the kits. We hope you all enjoy this weekend's video. Are you ready? Here we go.
On a glass ornament is painful. Inviting someone to church feels marvelous. So keep mittens away from the Christmas tree and invite someone to church.
What is your favorite thing about Christmas?
My favorite thing about Christmas, getting the present and putting Christmas decorations on the Christmas tree.
Since it's my brother's birthday, it's Christmas Eve, so we celebrate Christmas and my brother's birthday.
Open your present and get something.
Okay, what's the worst present you've ever gotten?
The worst present?
Clothes.
A brush.
A brush. You like your hair?
Yes.
The calendar that I eat, I have to eat healthy things all day and week.
What's the craziest news you've ever gotten that was true, but it was really hard to believe?
The longest shark, a shark that's as big as the longest worm.
What is an angel?
An angel is a messenger of God.
An angel is an angel.
It's like a butterfly, but just it's a human in the middle.
What's the first thing an angel usually says to a person?
Don't worry, God is here with you.
Wow, I feel really great. What does the name Emmanuel?
Avery's mom and Aiden's mom. Dad is named that.
Oh, his name's Emmanuel? Oh, that's good.
It means God with us.
Why was Jesus named Emmanuel?
Because he is basically God, because God's the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Sing the next line of this Christmas song. Silent night, holy night.
I forgot.
I forgot.
Thank you.
yo, yo, what is up, everybody? Hey, guys, look. Welcome to the Christmas Games. I'm so glad you all are here. So, guys, this is what's going to happen. I'm going to turn around. I'm going to look in one of these stockings, and I'm going to determine which game we're going to play. All right? Then, once I see what game we're going to play today, I'm going to challenge our good friend, Trey, a.k.a. Trey. Go Cray Cray. Are you guys ready? Oh, my goodness. We do this every time. Are you guys ready? Hey, all right, here we go. Drum roll, please. Let's see. Okay, this one. Here we go. Ooh, here we go. Game one, knock down the Christmas tree. All right, Trey, you ready? You're going down, bro. Let's go. How you all will play this game is you will have to stack the cups, right? So four on the bottom, three next, two, then one, and go to the other side of the table, and then roll the jingle bell and hit all of the cups until every single cup is off of the table, all right? Are you guys ready? Let's go!
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Here comes a new challenger!
Aaron!
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
All right, guys, how was that? You guys having fun? Guys, we're gonna keep it going, all right? For the next game, I'm gonna go back here and see what it is, all right? Here we go. All right, let's go. Guys, we're going to play the Great Jingle Bell Race. This is how you all will play the game, all right? You're gonna take one of the straws, all right? And then what's gonna happen is you have to blow this around each other cups, all right? Once you get to the end, you have to blow it off of the table. I know you guys can do it, all right? Cool, let's do it.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
and this time I'm going to be challenging
Mac.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
What's up, guys? I've got a question for you. How many of you out there have a birthday? Raise your hand. All right, that should be all of you. We all have birthdays. As we come to the month of December, we are getting ready to celebrate a very special birthday. And whose birthday is that? Hey, that's right. We're going to be celebrating Jesus' birthday. Over the next few weeks, as we participate in Advent, we are excited to do some really fun things to highlight how important Jesus is to us and how much we are looking forward to celebrating his birth. Many of you have picked up your KC Christmas kits, and you might have noticed that in that bag are supplies to bake a birthday cake. A good birthday celebration has to include a birthday cake, right? Obviously. This year, we hope you spend some time with your family and remember why we celebrate Christmas by making your very own birthday cake for Jesus. Speaking of making a birthday cake, let's check in on our very own Kids Church pastor, Viv, who invited a few of her grandkids over to do just that.
Hi, everyone. It's so good to see you all. I'm here in my kitchen with my grandkids, and we're going to bake our birthday cakes for Jesus right now. And we're so glad that you're with us. So, see, we've got our bags and all our supplies. So, kids, why don't you pull out the box that's inside your bag? Pull it out. This is going to be tricky. 3 eggs apiece.
Okay, let's do this.
Go ahead and tap it on the side of your bowl. Now, open it up. Good job. Okay, get all that egg out. All right. You don't want to touch that, do you? He doesn't like that kind of stuff. Okay, stick them in the box.
I have two.
All right, guess what? Why don't you guys start stirring that a little bit?
We're not done.
Now, guess what? We're ready for the mixer part.
Yeah!
Whoa, that's what this is. Now we get to pour your cakes into
the pan. No way!
We're making 5 cakes. Get up on your knees, Mickey. So you can help me
spread. I'm gonna eat the cakes.
Everybody's gonna get to taste a piece of cake.
My cake
More frosting.
Hey, can you help me?
Here. I think. Summer Jane!
Bagel.
That looks delicious!
Can I do it too?
You can do it, yeah, you can do it. That's why they're here.
Now it's time for sprinkling.
Whoa, that was beautiful.
No.
You two are doing a great job.
Hey, I don't have any more candy canes. I need a lot.
Uh-oh. Lucas, did you take all the candy canes? You guys are the best in the whole wide world. Do you think we have enough candy on these cakes?
Yeah.
No.
I don't have that much candy canes.
I don't have that much candy canes.
Ready?
Happy
birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Making our birthday cake for Jesus. See you soon. Bye.
Hey everyone, one thing I love the most about Christmas is gifts. I really love giving gifts because it's a way that I can show love and kindness to the people that I know. This year, Christian Assembly has been handing out bags of groceries to people who might need a little bit of help during this time. It's just one of the ways that we have been able to show God's love and kindness to others in our community. This Christmas, we want to bring even more joy to the people who will be receiving these groceries by including a card in the bag. So Kids Church has a really fun Christmas tree card for you to make, and I want to tell you all about it. In your KC Christmas kit, you have a bag labeled Prayer and Pantry. It looks like this. And in the bag is a card, an envelope, and some fun decorative Christmas paper. This is where it gets good. You are going to use the decorative paper to make a Christmas tree on the front of your card. First, you cut the decorative paper into long, thin strips, just like this. Make sure you cut it the long way so that you have lots of paper for your Christmas tree. Then you will start at the bottom of the card and slowly glue the strips of paper above to make a tree shape. To make that tree shape, you'll need to cut some of the strips to be shorter, like these ones up here. And when you finish your card, it will look a little bit like this. After you're done with the front of your card, write a message inside it, encouraging the person who will receive the groceries. You could write something simple like, Merry Christmas, or praying your Christmas is filled with joy, or even Jesus came to bring you hope. Or you can come up with your own Christmas message. When you're done decorating the front and writing a message inside, put the card back in the envelope we gave you and mail it to the church. Make sure to send your card back before Friday, December 11th. Then we will add your card to the grocery bags that will be handed out the next week. Just remember, this card is your opportunity to show God's love and kindness to a family who will receive the gift of groceries this Christmas season.
It's a Southern California winter storm out there, y'all. I counted 5 raindrops. Ooh, man, is it cold. Okay, hi, how's everybody doing? I'm here to celebrate the birthdays for the first week of December, okay? So I think I'm pretty well thought out and ready to go. All right, here we go. On December 5th, we have Sage and Inara. And on December 7th, we have Anthony and Keone. Happy birthday to all of you. I'm so happy for you. I hope you have an amazing and very warm happy birthday. Okay, so as is our tradition here, we're going to sing the last verse of the happy birthday song. But because it's so cold and frigid out there, we're gonna sing it in our best cold, freezing voice. Okay, are y'all ready? Here we go. Happy birthday to you. All right, happy birthday, everybody. I'm going to head back outside into the freezing cold blizzard conditions of Southern California. Wish me luck, all right?
Hi, Kids Church. In just a minute, we're going to worship God with our singing, one of my very favorite ways to worship. And I love that we can continue to worship God all throughout this Advent season. Even though Advent is a time of year that we focus a little more on waiting, we aren't going to wait to worship. And while singing is a way I love to worship, there are so many other things we can do to worship God as well. One of the ways that we worshiped God together in the building in Eagle Rock was that every week we would have a time where you could bring your money and give it as a worship offering to God. And we're going to keep giving you the opportunity to worship God in this way too, because we know that it is a good thing to worship God by giving Him our money. We know that He's asked us to do it, and we know that He only asks us to do things that are good. So as we worship God with our voices over the next few minutes, I encourage you to also bring Him your worship offering and put it in your family's offering bank. Do it with great joy as you think about who He is, how much He loves you, and all that He has done for you. Let's worship.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let her receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room, and heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and heaven and fields and floods, rocks, hills and
Hey guys, welcome back to our KC family experience. It's been great being able to celebrate Advent so far. Happy Advent! Last week we kicked off Advent by talking about hope. Do you remember what Advent means? It means waiting or arrival. So we are continuing to celebrate, to wait, and to look forward to Jesus coming to earth. That's what we're celebrating and waiting for. Remember, Christmas means celebrating Jesus, God's greatest gift. One of the things that I love is getting to hear all of the things that you are thankful for and what brings you joy. So I figured, why not do that right now? This is one of the ways that we get to worship God by reflecting on His creation, the gifts He has given us, and His love in our lives. So on the count of three, I want you to shout out one way God brought you joy this week. All right, you got it? All right, ready? One, two, three. My cat. Hey, I love it. While I may not be able to hear all the ways God has brought you joy into your life this week, it's amazing to know that we're all worshiping and thanking God for the joy He has given us. Speaking of joy, today we're going to be focusing on the word joy. So let's jump into our story today and see the joy that God will bring.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Luke, chapter 1, verses 26 through 56.
Mary lived in the tiny town of Nazareth, an ordinary village at the edge of Jewish lands.
Nazareth? Can anything good come from there?
Mary herself was an ordinary girl.
Oh, hello.
She grew up learning the Jewish scriptures.
A child will be born to us, a son will be given to us. He will rule over us, and He will be called Wonderful Advisor and Mighty God. When will this happen?
Only God knows. It's been hundreds of years.
Mary went to fetch water from the well and baked loaves of bread and swept out the hard-packed earth floor.
It's important to clean the dirt off the dirt.
She was also engaged to be married to a carpenter named Joseph. Mary must have expected that her life would follow a very ordinary path, until one day when everything changed.
Greetings, Mary.
Suddenly, right there in the dim room, a brilliant being appeared. Mary probably dropped whatever she was holding, a broom, a batch of bread dough, a needle and thread.
Who? Me?
The Lord has blessed you in a special way. He is with you.
Mary blinked, trying to take it all in. The whole room glowed with light.
I don't understand.
Do not be afraid, Mary. God is very pleased with you.
Mary couldn't find any words. In one heartbeat, her very ordinary day had flipped upside down.
You will become pregnant and give birth to a son. You must call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High God. He will rule forever over His people. That kingdom will never end.
The words of Isaiah may have echoed in Mary's head.
A child will be born to us. A son will be given to us. He will rule over us.
She finally found her voice.
How can this happen? I'm not even married yet.
The light flared even brighter.
The Holy Spirit will make this happen. Your relative Elizabeth will have a child even though she is old. People thought she could not have children, but she has been pregnant for 6 months now. That's because what God says will always come true.
Mary's heart pounded. Her cousin Elizabeth was old enough to be a grandmother, and if she was having a baby, anything could happen.
I serve the Lord. May it happen to me just as you said it would.
The light faded. The towering angel disappeared. Mary leaned against the wall to collect her thoughts.
Elizabeth, I have to go see her.
The journey to Elizabeth and Zechariah's home in the hill country of Judah would have taken many days of travel along dusty roads. Finally, Mary arrived.
Why, it's Mary.
Elizabeth, I have so much to tell you.
As Mary spoke, Elizabeth could feel the child inside of her leap and kick for joy. God's Holy Spirit spoke to Elizabeth.
God has blessed you more than other women, and blessed is the child you will have. As soon as I heard the sound of your voice, the baby inside of me jumped for joy. You are a woman God has blessed. You have believed that the Lord would keep his promises to you.
Mary laughed and cried at the same time as she hugged her older cousin. God confirmed once again that Mary could find joy in the extraordinary plan God had for her.
Now tell me your story.
Mary stayed with Elizabeth for several weeks. She was so filled with joy, she poured out her heart in a song to God.
My soul gives glory to the Lord. My spirit delights in God, my Savior. He has taken note of me, even though I'm not considered important. He shows his mercy to those who have respect for him. He has filled with good things those who are hungry. He has helped the people of Israel who serve him. He has done it just as he had promised to our people of long ago.
At the end of 3 months, Mary returned home to Nazareth, ready to see how God's plan was about to unfold.
Wow. Do you know what I love about that story? I love how God had a plan for Mary and for Elizabeth too. He showed that he knows everything about them, and he chose them to be part of the big story that he was creating to send Jesus to earth to be our Savior. The truth is, God has a good plan for each of us. You can have joy because God has a plan for you. I mean, it must have been pretty shocking for Mary when she heard the news from the angel. I know I would have been shocked. I know she could never have imagined that she'd be the mother of the Savior of the world. It's pretty wild. I'm sure the words from the prophets came to her mind that for a child is born to us, a son is given to us. Could it be that she would be part of God's plan to bring peace to the earth? The angel told Mary to name the baby Jesus. The name Jesus means the Lord saves. And that's exactly what God was going to do. Gabriel told Mary that Jesus would be the king and that his kingdom would never end. While she didn't fully understand how everything would work out, Mary trusted God. She believed that God had a good plan for her life, even though she was scared. Can you imagine the joy that Mary felt that day? That God had chosen her to be part of his plan? Guess what? That joy that she experienced wasn't just for her. It's for us too. Because God has a plan for each of us. We can trust God too. We can trust him no matter what. That's how we find joy. Real joy comes from knowing that God has a plan for you. Even when things don't work out the way you expected, you can find joy in knowing that God is with you and he's working toward that good plan that he has for you. God's plan to send Jesus to be Mary's son is part of his good plan for you and for me too. God sent Jesus to rescue you because he loves you so much. It says in Romans 8:28, "And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purposes for them." God has good plans for us. And because of that, we can have joy. Speaking of joy, we continue to celebrate Advent today by lighting both the hope candle and the joy candle. These candles represent the hope and joy that we experience in the birth of Jesus. Let's light these candles. We light the candle of hope for the hope that Jesus brings. And we light the candle of joy, the joy of his salvation. And in just a minute, you as a family are going to get to light these candles as well. You see, biblical joy is an attitude people have, not because of happy circumstances, but because of God's love and promises. Joy isn't saying bad things won't happen, or that we won't be sad. Those things are going to happen because we live in a sinful world that is broken. Instead, It's trusting that Jesus has a plan for your life, and choosing to be joyful for what he has done, is doing, and what he will do. We saw that God had a plan for Mary, Elizabeth, and Jesus. He has a plan for you too, and it's that you would experience the joy of his salvation. You can always have joy when you remember that God has a good plan for your life. In our story today, we saw that the angel Gabriel came to Mary to deliver good news of great joy. That word, angel, it means messenger. Did you know that God is calling us to be his messengers too? How amazing is that? One of the greatest things that brings me joy is when I get to see new people experience Jesus. Last week, Becca led us begin to pray for a family that we can invite to our online Christmas service on December 19th. I want to lead us in our next step, which is to pray for this family. After we pray together, I invite you to get your Advent wreath and candles and spend some time together as a family talking more about joy. Let's pray. Jesus, we come to you first to thank you for all that you have done. We thank you that you have a plan. You had a plan for Mary's life and for ours too. Thank you for sending your son to this earth to be our savior. God, we know that you want our friends and neighbors to experience the joy of knowing you. Lord, would you help us know who we should invite to watch the Casey family experience? Let's pause and listen and ask God which family or friends we should invite. Now, ask God that this family would be open to hearing your invitation. Ask God that he would remove any barriers that these families or friends are facing from watching our Casey Family Service. Lastly, pray that this family would experience the joy that only Jesus brings to our lives. Pray that many of our friends and neighbors would come to love and serve you. We thank you for your love, Jesus. Amen. May you experience God's joy as you spend time together as a family.
Hi friends, as we continue to move along towards the end of the year, we want to say thank you for being part of our Kids Church family experience each week. We enjoy spending a little time with you each week. We thought you might like a change of pace now and a few knock-knock jokes. Knock-knock!
Who's there?
Wayne!
Wayne who?
A Wayne in a manger!
Oh!
Bye guys!